इंडिया हैज़ करेंटली 120 मिलियन एल्डर्स अबव द एज ऑफ 60. 5 years बैक इट वॉज अबाउट 110 मिलियन, एंड 5 years फ्रॉम नाउ वी आर लुकिंग एट अबाउट 180 मिलियन एल्डर्स इन दिस कंट्री. सो दिस इज रफली 3 times द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स एल्डरली पॉपुलेशन. रफली अबाउट 20 years फ्रॉम नाउ इन इंडिया वट इज 1 in 10 पीपल बींग एन एल्डर, इट विल बिकम 1 in 5. So what it means is that as a nation, we will have to really think how 300 million elders who are elderly will have to be taken care of. And this cannot be done by looking at it from one perspective. Whether it is business, whether it is policy makers, whether it is the ecosystem, everything will have to fall together so that elderly can be taken care of in a better way. And that is the elderly health industry that is coming together to take care of elders' health. And in India, we are going to be leading that that growth, because for us the home has always been the center. For us, communities taking care of the elderly has always been the center. For us, the way we are able to do a holistic health and not just clinical health has always been the power. And fourth and most importantly, the power of having digital health. We are living in a year where the budget came digital, and I think as we move forward, health being digital and digitally being served married with the local community doctors and local community services is going to be the new norm, and which will pave the future for the world also to follow. So the world of an elder has always had different kinds of challenges, and while in the Western world there is a more institutionalized support system for taking care of elders, whether it is emergency systems, whether it is the social pension systems, the social support systems, none of that exists in India. And therefore, at an India level, we'll have to think of much deeper institutionalized mechanism, policy-supported mechanisms for taking care of our elders. Currently, which is not there. And therefore, whether it's an infra of an elder who is sick, who has an emergency, we don't have the kind of emergency response system the way it is abroad. If there is somebody who needs deeper financial support, the kind of pension systems that are there, or the kind of insurance reform systems which are there abroad, or insurance innovations which are there, is still to happen in India. And I think these are the kind of challenges which can translate into opportunities as the Indian ecosystem for elderly improves. I did my schooling in urban planning at School of Planning and Architecture 23 years back. And having spent time in how neighborhoods are planned and how a city is planned, I realized how our cities are actually not designed for elders in the right way. And having spent 20 years working in different corporates in different capacities, in the year 2018, towards the end of the year, it felt very, very natural and very important that we do something for the needs and taking care of elders of the country. And one thing which always used to bother me was that our parents, my own parents, my in-laws, have had many emergency situations, health situations, they've had falls in their home. And every time something like that used to happen, I used to always wonder that what if I was not there? What if my wife was not there at that point of time? Something very severe could have happened. My parents and my in-laws have also had extremely active lives. And after, they turned 60, till date, they would always want to be very, very active. So in a very personal capacity, I have seen how important it is to look at the life of an elder in a slightly different spirit. And this is what IMOHA brought into the table. IMOHA is a connected community of elders. And this is a family of elders who are active, who are engaged, who are safe, who are secure. And the community and all those who are serving the community are an engaged community which are helping elders live life to the fullest in their own existing home. My parents would never want to move out of their own home. And 99% of India's population would like to stay in their own home. They would like to have all the enjoyments of staying at home while doing everything that they would like to do, fulfilling the dreams that they would have, and being an independent, like a free bird. And that is the spirit that IMOHA brings to the table of how we can connect the disconnected world of an elder. An elder has many different types of disconnects in his life, which, as we discussed, because of the absence of social support systems, they have to face it on their own. With a population where more than 40% elders stay alone, with so much health issues, emergency issues, routine day-to-day hassles that they have to take care, and life becoming lonely after a point of time, it is this small little interventions that IMOHA members benefit from, which can make their life much, much more thriving and independent for as long as they want, however they want. It doesn't matter whether you have health issues. It doesn't matter if you have any other concerns. If we can stitch the connects together in your own community and stream it into your own home, we are happy. So today Emoha has roughly about 600 members across the country. We started in 2018, and after a year or so, where we spent a lot of time building the systems, in the last year, which has pretty much been the COVID year, the community has grown from about 50-60 members to now about 600 members. And these are members who stay active. They are, you know, they are people who have had very good careers in their life and today play an active role in engaging themselves. They come online 3 times a day. They have engaging programs that they participate in and stay busy all the time. Emoha plans to keep this spirit of being independent and engaged in whatever the elders want to do.